This is a video how-to on how to configure Microsoft Outlook 2010 to access your UW email from the student residence halls and off campus. Once you have your Outlook installed, you're going to go to Start and choose Control Panel. By default, your Control Panel will probably go to this Category view, which is a little harder. So what I'll have you do is change from the Category view to either the large or small icons. In this case, I'll just choose large icons. And I want to double-click the Mail 32-bit icon. This will bring up a mail setup window. You'll want to click on the Show Profiles dot 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 button, and then you'll add a new profile by clicking Add dot dot dot. You'll give it a profile name. In this case, I'll say Outlook Anywhere, but it can be anything, UW email or your name slash email or your name space email. But we'll just use Outlook Anywhere for this video. And I'll click OK. This will bring me to a configuration page where I can add the new account. By default, it's going to go to an auto account setup. You're going to want to change that to manually configure server settings or additional server types and click Next. At the service choice window, you're going to choose Microsoft Exchange or compatible service and click Next. That'll bring you to a server settings window. For the first server name in that box, you'll type Pony Express -mb1.uwio.edu. You will leave the Use Cached Exchange Mode box checked, and for the username, you will type the username you're trying to access. In this case, I'll go with the Help Desk User Help Account. You'll next click the More Settings dot 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 button and click to the Connection tab. At the Connection tab is a checkbox at the bottom called Connect to Microsoft Exchange using HTTP. Check that and then click on the Exchange Proxy Server Settings box. Here, you'll type uwmail.uwio.edu under the connection settings, and you'll check the On Fast Networks Connect using HTTP first. Then you'll click OK. You'll click OK at the next window, and then you can just click Next. It'll take a few minutes for it to look at the configuration before it comes up with a Finish box. Once you get to this screen saying congratulations, you'll click Finish, and then on this screen here you will check the profile that you created for always use this profile, so make sure that's checked with whatever you named it and click OK. You can close out a control panel, and at that point you can go ahead and click on to access your Outlook. The first time you use this configuration, it will prompt you to enter your username and password. In this case, I'll do the password I created. And click OK. It may ask a couple times. If it does, just keep entering that username and password. Once you're able to authenticate, Outlook will show the Preparing Outlook for First Use message and give you a percentage of things to happen before it opens up. As it loads the email, you'll notice down towards the bottom it'll say updating this folder. The main thing you want to see is the connected to Microsoft Exchange. As long as you're connected, that mail will start to come in. If you have any problems during the installation or configuration of Outlook, please contact the help desk at 307-766-4357, option number 1.